is it hard for you to not sometimes give in to that resentment toward people who thought that this was acceptable, and honestly, people who still think it's acceptable, because it's a tight race right now between him and Joe Biden.
It would be disingenuous to say, like, I think there are a lot of people who, like, don't take responsibility, who do bear responsibility. And, you know, the people who were very transparent about, like, voting because they wanted a tax cut, okay, but, like, you knew you also were voting for, like, a racist, Islamophobic, like, anti-Semitic, like, misogynistic, transphobic human being who was going to have a lot of power to manifest those, like, hateful, bigoted values into the world. So that maybe was your motivation, and that may be the story that you tell yourself, but you can't then avoid kind of some responsibility for what has happened, because, okay, I didn't know that he was so grossly going to mismanage a global pandemic and constantly be undermining the CDC and the FDA. Although I'm not terribly surprised, because he's trying to win the next election, and that is kind of the only metric of success he cares about, not like actually saving Americans' lives. But like, he told us that he would try to ban immigrants. Like, he told us that he would cut taxes and like gut the already too small social safety net in our country. Like, he told us repeatedly how he feels about women. So of course it's not surprising that he's tried to restrict a woman's right to choose or women's ability to access healthcare broadly. So like, this was not the writing on the wall. Like, you didn't have to be as maybe engaged as I am. Like, you just had to listen to one or two of his speeches or tune into one of the debates. Like, he told us and showed us like who he is repeatedly in 2015 and 2016.